This is such a happy discovery. This is so good. The year was 1948. A young school dropout, G Pulla Reddy, came to Kurnool, which was then the capital of Andhra Pradesh, to set up a sweet shop. That sweet shop became the iconic G Pulla Reddy, with branches across Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and fans of its sweet offerings, of its delicious mithai across the world. Let's go and taste some delicious mithai at G Pulla Reddy. So we're at the first outlet of G Pulla Reddy Sweets. Actually, the first outlet began near Konda Reddy Burj, which is the famous fort, the Purana Killa here in Kurnool. And about 40 years ago, the sweet shop moved to its present location. That's Mr. G Pulla Reddy, who began G Pulla Reddy Sweets. So Mr. Jagannatham and Mr. Raghava Reddy look after the oldest outlet of G Pulla Reddy. Sabse oldest sweet kaun sa hai?
Oldest bol to Khova Puri sa.
Khova Puri.
Khova Puri, Badusha, Mysore Pak.
So we're beginning with some of the oldest sweets made here at G Pulla Reddy. So we've got the Khova Puri, which I'm told is one of the oldest offerings here and still very popular. And then of course you have the Badusha and the Mysore Pak. Oh, Mysore Pak kaisa bana? Mysore Pak to Mysore ka hai na?
Mysore Pak Pulla Reddy ka famous hai.
Pulla Reddy ka famous. Ghee se banata hai, lekin thoda hard hai na ye aapka Mysore Pak.
Naram bhi hai.
Acha? So इसमें क्या difference है ये दो मैसूर पाक?
ये नरम रोटा साहब, ये हार्ड रोटा।
दोनों घी से बनाता है।
पूरा घी से बनाता है।
पूरा घी से बनाता है। So all sweets here at G Pulla Reddy are made with pure ghee. And I'm told, and I've read this up, when G Pulla Reddy first came to Kurnool to begin the sweet shop, he insisted on making sweets of the highest possible quality, which meant using the most pure ghee that he could find available. So, and therefore the prices of G Pulla Reddy at that point in time in 1948 was higher than what other sweet stores were charging. But very soon people tasted the sweets and understood the quality of it. And therefore, as they say, the rest is history. So I'm going to begin by tasting the Khova Puri, which is hugely popular, which is very old and much recommended. You have that maida casing, but that maida casing serves only to hold the sugary sweet Khova that is there inside. You can taste that buttery goodness of the ghee and of the dairy, of the Khova that's there in this Khova Puri. You can see the layers of the dough and the ghee that's gone into it along with the Khova. Mmm. That was a delicious start to our mithai tasting here at G Pulla Reddy. I think next we're gonna go for the Badusha. And the Badusha is nothing but a crusty maida cookie that's encased in a sugar syrup. I don't think you can get a sweet as simple as this. Maida, ghee, sugar, and of course, deep fried goodness. The texture of this Badusha is crumbly on the outside and gooey inside. You can taste the richness of the ghee in this dough. And of course, the sugary kick that you get from the sweet. Mm. The Mysore Pak is also a popular offering here at G Pulla Reddy. And they make two versions. The original version that they make is a hard, crumbly, biscuity sort of a Mysore Pak. And then they also have a softer Mysore Pak that I'm told came much later. So let's taste the older version of the Mysore Pak here. You can see the color variation in this Mysore Pak. So you've got this light going to a slightly deeper brown. I suspect the deeper brown color comes from the roasting of the Mysore Pak, of the paka in that kadai. So texture wise, it's quite crumbly. It's not really the sort that melts in your mouth. You know, what's interesting is that this Mysore Pak is a combination of certain parts which I suspect would melt in the mouth, and that's the light yellow part. And then you have that biscuity, deeper brown part of the Mysore Pak, which lingers on your palate. That certainly is more crumbly, it's more biscuity. It's a sort of Mysore Pak that you hold on to in your palate and you savour it for a while. You savour that sweet goodness of that Mysore Pak. Let's also taste a bit of the soft Mysore Pak. This is unbelievably soft. This just breaks under its own weight. That just dissolves in your mouth. It's ghee that goes into both the Mysore Paks. One crumbly and one unbelievably melt in the mouth. So I just guess it's a matter of your personal preference, whether you like your Mysore Pak hard and crumbly, or if you like your Mysore Pak absolutely melt in the mouth. Both of them delicious though. Aur kya try karna chahiye yahan pe?
Kon gaddi kar raha tha sir?
So wheat jo dalta hai wo pani mein dalta hai wo sprout hota hai the germinate
char din mein baad aate na
ha
jab nikal ke bil sukne dalte hai
sukane dalte hai
ha sukha ho gaya baad aata pakadne baad sonpatti banate
hai lovely. So staying with the classic mithai here at G Pulla Reddy, we've got another one. This is the Sohan Patti, which is also known as the gut mithai, I'm told, for people who come from Mumbai. And this is another speciality here at G Pulla Reddy. So it's basically germinated wheat, sugar and ghee. And he's cut this for me because it's a very hard candy sort of a sweet. It feels hard initially, but it just breaks into this gooey, sticky sort of a mass. What you really find is a texture of the sweet, which is that gooey, gummy, sticky sort of a texture. It's a lot of ghee, no? What you taste is all that ghee that's gone into this Sohan Patti. Storage jada hai.
Storage bhi jada.
This is a mithai that can easily stay for a month or two because of the pure ghee that's used in this. I'm quite tempted to go for another piece of this Sohan Patti or gut mithai. This is a combination of crunch, some sticky texture there. Makes you just want to chew on it for a bit. Certainly an interesting mithai.
Nikal pura paper.
So, ये पूरा खा सकता है?
पूरा सब खाने का है तो?
खाने का है?
Wow!
ये भी घी का है?
ये भी घी का है. This is the world famous Pootharekulu or paper sweet. This is actually rice flour, sugar,
ghee.
And ghee that is fashioned into these thin sheets, which are almost like paper. Wow! You can see how transparent this sweet is. And that's why it's called the paper sweet. I've never tasted this before. So this, I'm told, is one of the newer sweets here at G Pulla Reddy. Actually, it's quite unnerving because when you hold it, it feels like you're holding paper. But you're going to eat this paper. So the first bite, first impression on the palate, you taste nothing. Literally feel like you've put a thin piece of paper in your mouth. And then, once that thin piece of paper dissolves, you then taste the sugar and the ghee. This is such a clever mithai. And there is another version which is similar but made with jaggery. It opens up like a sheet of paper, but it has jaggery in it and ghee. So you can see these brown flecks, that's nothing but the jaggery. And I'm told it's the regular jaggery that's used. The jaggery that they get locally out here. You can also see a thick fleck of jaggery right here. Let's taste the jaggery Pootharekulu. Pootharekulu is what it was called. Now it's called Pootharekulu or paper sweet. I like this one even better because it has that earthy sweetness of the jaggery. Sugar Pootharekulu is a little sweet because once you taste the rice paper, you're then tasting the sugar and the ghee, which kind of makes it a little sweet after the first bite. But this one has a jaggery, and that jaggery has that earthy sweetness. This is such a delightful find here in Kurnool. All that you first taste is what you would taste if, let's say, you put paper in your mouth. But then, as that thin, translucent paper dissolves, you taste the goodness of that ghee and that jaggery that's rolled into this Pootharekulu. This is such a happy discovery. I'm quite tempted to finish this entire thing, although I still think I'm going to taste a couple more mithai. Why not? This is the khova, the milk that is reduced down to milk solids along with sugar. And I'm told this is also very popular here, very famous here. Locally, I'm told in Kurnool. So the paper sweet that we tasted is about 10 odd years old, but these sweets, the khova, the Mysore Pak, the Badusha, the Khova Puri are the original sweets here at G Pulla Reddy. You can taste the lightly caramelized, toasty notes of the milk as it has turned into a milk solid over a period of time on fire. And that lends the khova a light, toasty, caramelized sort of a flavor. This is so good. I think the ultimate deliciousness lies in the simplest of foods. And some of the mithai that I've tasted here is testament to that. Especially this pure khova here at G Pulla Reddy. So basically the tasting here has largely been basis recommendations, basis what they've recommended here as the oldest sweets and of course some of the newer sweets and the recommendations that we've got on social media. So I'm literally tasting most of the sweets that you asked me to taste here at G Pulla Reddy. And this kaju barfi is just another one of them. So this is similar to a kaju katli. Those from the north would probably identify with this, but this is thicker. It's thicker like a barfi, and of course you've got the silver sheet, the varak, as a garnish on top. You definitely taste the richness of that cashew. I also get the hint of a spice. I'm not sure if there's cardamom that's gone into it, but there's the subtle lilt of a sweet spice. What I also like is the fact that the sugars in this are very toned down. So it's not punch in your face sort of sugary, but it's more mellower. What you really taste is the goodness of the cashew paste, with that gentle lilt of that sweet spice. So if you'd like a decadent slice of history, do drop by at Kurnool at G Pulla Reddy, the first store where it all began, as they say, and savor some delicious mithai. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating.